Alright, so here are your two sets of rocker arms side by side for the Dodge Viper. This one here is the Gen 2, made from 96 to 2002. You can see it's completely stamped. It has a just a regular friction style trunnion on it, and friction, I don't know what we call this part, the tip. Okay, cheap cast stamp locator. I don't know what to say about it. Not a very expensive piece there. Okay. Here's a Gen 3. This is a 1.7 ratio rocker, so you get an extra lift over the Gen 2. You also get the nicer roller trunnion. Yay! You still don't get a roller end tip on it. So setting up your push rod lengths it's less than perfect. You can see the wear pattern on these already. It's got a fairly wide, zoom in there, there you go. It's got a fairly wide wear pattern, which means that's how far this thing is scrubbing on the tip of the valve. If this thing was set up perfectly from the factory, then it'd be just a small, small wear area in the middle. Okay. So anyway, that's what this is. You can see it's not a bad looking piece. I think it's pretty similar to what the LS guys get. Die cast metal as opposed to stamped. So yeah, nice little upgrade for all you Gen 2 guys out there. So, and these things are pretty cheap. Like I say, you usually pick these things up on Viper Rally for a couple hundred bucks a set as people upgrade them to Tindy studge systems and stuff like that. All right, so I have set this number one piston to top dead center, and I've verified that the push rods are properly located in their position. Okay, now we're going to bolt these rocker arms on. One of the things you need to check is your preload. See right there, I'm already bumping up against the lifter. That's tight. And that's tight right there. All right. If I were to tighten these things down, you can see my valves are now opening up, which is a big problem when you're supposed to be at top dead center. So I am going to remove these rockers, and I'm going to apply a 1/8 inch shim underneath them. Now it's also possible my push rods are too long. Still rolling? Okay, so this is actually a 90/1000ths shim. I lied to you. 90/1000ths. So we'll place that in there and we'll reinstall these and check our preload. I don't know if you guys watched my earlier video when I talked about how the Gen 3 valves are longer than the Gen 2 valves by about 1/100 of an inch. Okay, that's why I'm going with a 90/1000ths shim to make up that difference. the exhaust is starting to hit. And right there, the intake is starting to hit. Hang on a second here. This exhaust is moving around a lot. Let's see what's going on here. Everything looks right there. So, let me bolt this in place without the push rod. Okay, there it is. Okay, no push rod installed. Okay, I don't know if you guys can see this. But we are, wow. Quite a bit off on our links, okay? So, this either needs to be a much shorter push rod, or we need some more shims. This camshaft is bigger than the factory camshaft. They don't actually make the lobe on a performance camshaft taller, but they make the base circle smaller in order to give you more lift out of that same lobe. So when you go to a performance camshaft, you usually go to a longer push rod so that you can reach the smaller base diameter of your camshaft. Okay, and yet here I'm showing that I need a shorter push rod. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull these off again. I don't think I need a shorter push rod. I'm going to use a second shim underneath here and see how it lines up. All right, I just checked it and it is another 90,000th shim. So first, I'm going to go ahead and snug this down and just see how it feels. Look, I'm already getting tight now, and there's actually a little bit of play on that exhaust rocker. Let's tighten the intake. And also, the intake has a little bit of play in there as well. About the same amount. How about that? Okay. So, now the question is, do we need longer push rods for the performance cam that we have installed, or do we need to take some shims out? Alright, so now I've got another small piece of aluminum shim stock. Comes in right at 1/25 of an inch. So I'm going to use that as my shim so I can double check my lifter preload with my current push rods. you just want to go snug. Don't go too tight on these guys. I'm not using a full width shim, so if I tighten these things down too hard, I will actually bend the alignment bar. So that's all the way down. Let's undo this just a few turns. Slide our push rod in there, and let's see how this feels. Well, locked into the keeper, that's for sure. All right, there is zero. I'm gonna do the same thing on the intake. Right there, there is zero. And like I said, hydraulic lifters, these move around a little bit right now because they're not locked down. So ideally you want like 1/4 to 1/2 of a turn before they tighten. So let's see here. There's 1/2, oh, right there, 1/2, right there. Let's try the other one. Not quite 1/2. All right, so we've got 1/2 of a turn, give or take, on each of these for our lifter preload. So I'm actually happy with that, but now we need to check our valve train geometry. To check our valve train geometry, I am going to color the tip of the valve with a marker. That. And we will retype these. There, just snug, don't go too tight. Snug. And again, these things aren't wiggling around anymore. We've got a little preload on them. So let's turn this engine over a couple of turns. All right, there's the exhaust again. And the intake, and we should be coming up on top dead center, so I'm watching the crank right there, top dead center. Let's look at our pattern. So here is our results of our test. Using the 125 shim, you can see the rocker arm starts here. As we go to max lift, it goes right out here to the edge. Doesn't quite go over the top. I'm not a real fan of the design of that rocker tip. I'd rather have a roller tip myself. But I have to say though, when you're getting out here, boy, you've got max lift going on. I'd rather see that max lift closer to the center of the valve, and one way we can achieve that is to actually shrink the push rods a little bit. If we shrink the push rods, that's going to pull this inside measurement inward a little bit more and pull this back. It'll help to center this valve, center this rocker over that valve tip. So I'm going to measure these push rods and I'm going to see what we have available in a slightly smaller length. right, so based on those previous measurements, I took one of my push rods and I cut it in half and re-welded it. It is now 1/8 of an inch shorter than my old one, so 125 thousandths. So we're right at 7.5 inches now, instead of 7.625. With this smaller push rod, I won't need as much of a shim, so I'm going to put my old 90 thousandths shim back in there and see how my geometry looks. So go ahead and run down. I'm just going to do the exhaust for now. I only have one push rod. I'll tighten that down. Again, just like before, I want to pay attention to how, oh my gosh, how much clearance I have. Wow. An eighth of an inch makes a huge amount of difference in the gap here. So, okay, let's take out the shim altogether. Wasn't expecting quite that much difference. Like I said, usually when you go to a performance camshaft, you need to get slightly longer push rods. But I decked my block, my heads are decked, and I'm using a thinner head gasket. And those things add up. This is just the rocker directly on the base. Let's see how this looks. Gotta pay attention to the preload. That is touching the valve, so let's check our preload. There's a half, and about a 3/4 of a turn on the preload. That's not bad. Let's look at our geometry. Wow, we are way off on the edge here. I'm not sure if I'm gonna like that. Let's run this through. And we'll see how it looks here. Okay, here we go. Well, it looks pretty flat when the valve was at max lift. That's actually not so bad. All right, and I'm gonna stop this thing at top dead center, and let's look at our pattern. I thought it was gonna look worse than that. Okay, bringing the camera over. All right, so here, now you can see we were at base circle, we're way back here, and as we go through the lift, we're stopping here. So we're actually too far on this side. So if we can split our difference, between those two readings will be dead on. So, let's see, 7.625 down to 7.5. Let's go half of that, probably about 7.55 or 7.6. We'll have to make a decision. All right, just got my brand new set of comp cams, chromoly push rods. These are in size 7.50 inches length, and they are 5/16 diameter. Very nice push rods. I use these on my solid roller Pontiac 455, so it can handle the abuse much nicer than these factory push rods. So we'll be installing these and we'll see how the geometry looks. Alright, well, make sure you don't have any junk inside your push rods and blow them out with air or do something, double check them. But the first thing we gotta do is check our preload. So I'm gonna drop these in there. I wanna see how this looks. I'm not using any shims right now on my rocker stand. That's tight already. All right, so let's back this one off just a hair. Okay, see the spacing, right there. That is 0 preload, so I'm gonna go half, 1 and maybe a third, about 1 1/4 maybe. Preload. That's too much. Let's see how the other one does. Let's back this off a little bit. Okay, so there's 0. We'll tighten this. Half. 1. Okay, that's not too bad. But we gotta fix this one here. So I'm gonna use a thin shim to pull this rocker up just a hair so we can adjust that preload. Okay, so now I've got a 90,000th shim I'm going to drop in here, if I don't drop my rocker arms, and we're going to check that preload again. At this point, I do not have my oil pan on the block. If you drop something, you want to be able to get it back out. So let's go down to 0. Uh-oh, there's 0, and I still got space. I got 0 preload. Negative. Same thing with my intake. So I've got negative preload on both of these. So that means I need to find a thinner spacer. Really, really close. Now I could change the push rod length on these things. Let's see here. I would either need a slightly longer push rod if I was gonna keep this spacer, or I need a shorter push rod if I were gonna go with out the spacer. Typically speaking, Dodge Viper engines will run push rods in the 7.50 range up to about 7.60, 7.65, something like that. So I'm already on the low range of what is considered to be normal for a push rod. But like I said, my heads are shaved, my deck is blocked. try it again. My heads are shaved, my block is decked, and I'm using a thinner gasket. So I expect to be using shorter push rods. So that 7.50 length should be good. So let's get a thinner shim. All right, so now I've got a 50/1000 thick steel shim that I'm going to try. And we will see how our preload looks. So right there is zero, and zero for the intake. And we've got a little less than half a turn on the exhaust. And about the same on the intake. A quarter turn on the intake. That is minimal preload. Well, let's go ahead and run this thing through a couple revolutions and see how our pattern is on our valve stem tip. There's the exhaust, intake, and then top dead center. One more time. Exhaust, intake, and coming up on top dead center. All right, so here is my wear pattern with the 7.50 push rods and the 50/1000 shims. You can see it still starts pretty far on the inside edge there and doesn't quite balance out. On the intake, same thing, it starts down here on this edge and doesn't quite balance out. So I think I'm gonna go with another 50/1000 longer push rod before I put this thing back together. Okay, this is my number 9 cylinder here. And you can see my valve tip pattern looks a lot better here and here. I'm going pretty much from one side to the other side. It looks fairly balanced to me. I'm actually liking this pattern a bit more than the number 1 cylinder. So I'm going to measure a couple more before I decide if I want to return those push rods back or not. All right, this is my number 5 cylinder. You can see on the exhaust, I think I got my camera right, okay. The wear pattern is right splat dab in the middle of my valve tip. That's beautiful. Over here on the intake, again, it goes from about, oh, it's hard to show. There you go. From there to there. Right in the middle. So those 7.50s are looking pretty good. I'm going to rotate the engine. Let's do a couple on the other side. All right, this is my number 2 cylinder here. And you can see that my wear pattern goes from about here on the edge up to about there with my exhaust valve. And over here, it's from the edge also to about there. So this cylinder here would really benefit from slightly longer push rods as well. So we'll have to see what we can do there. Let's measure some of these other ones and see what happens. All right, here's my number 4 cylinder. Exhaust, bam, right in the middle. Intake, bam, right in the middle. So we'll keep the 7.50s for that number 4. Well, this is the number 6 cylinder. Again, pattern right in the middle, exhaust and intake. So keeping the 7.50s for the number 6. Right, so this is the number 8 cylinder. And you can see again, the mark there to there. It's a good wear pattern on the exhaust. And over there, here to there, right in the middle for the intake. So I've only got a few more cylinders to do. I don't know what the heck happened to cylinders number 1 and 2, but we'll be double checking those here in a little bit. All right, cylinder number 10. Perfect with a 7.50 push rods. Back to number 2 again. And you can still see my pattern. This is the second time to check it. Pattern is still a little bit on the inside here. Both valve stem tips. But one thing I didn't mention before is that my hydraulic plungers on my lifters are collapsing as I rotate this engine around. So when the engine is actually running, I will get more lift, which will push this pattern a little bit more to the outside edge. So I think I'm gonna run with this and see how it goes. Anyway, that is how I set up my rocker arm geometry. Some people like to use those push rod length checkers, but those push rod length checkers go on the assumption that every rocker arm has the exact same geometry, that the trunnion and the valve stem tip and where the push rod goes are all the same on every rocker ever made. And I don't believe that's correct. So I don't use those push rod length checkers. I'd rather do it this way. It's a little bit more time consuming, but I think we get a better result than just trusting what that checker tells you. Let me know what you think in the comments. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you on the next video.